Hello, people. Today I will be doing a comparison of the yet-to-be-announced iPhone 6 with the Samsung Galaxy S5. In this comparison, the iPhone 6 will be represented by all the leaked info and photos that we have of the phone, although this is subject to change. With that said, most of the major updates to the next-gen iPhone have been leaked and have a very high chance of becoming reality. In this video, I will be focusing on the following aspects of each phone: build quality, the size of the display, added features of the phone, speed, battery life, and the camera quality. Lastly, I will not be talking about the UI because it is just too opinionated. And at this point in human history, you should know what mobile operating system you like the best. Getting into this video, the Samsung Galaxy S5 has a good build quality when considering that it is completely made out of plastic, but against the iPhone 6 and its alleged new aluminum unibody design, there's just no competition between a plastic phone and a phone made out of aluminum. The S5 has a 1080p Full HD display coming in at 5.1 inches, giving the phone a pixel density of 432. The iPhone 6 is speculated to come in two sizes, a 4.7 inch display and one that has a 5.5 inch display. The model that has the 5.5 inch display is not as well leaked and could be delayed at launch, so in this video I will be focusing on the phone with the smaller display size. So like I said, the display of the iPhone 6 is going to be 4.7 inches and is speculated to have a resolution of about 1700 by 960. This means the pixel density will be 416. Special features of the Galaxy S5 include, but is not limited to, the following: a fitness tracking device that calculates your beats per minute. It has a removable back plate, changeable battery, expandable storage via microSD, IP67 water and dust resistant, and it has a fingerprint scanner in the home button. Special features of the iPhone go as following: it has an amazing build quality, Touch ID, a super thin design. Lastly, it is also supposed to use new glass on the display that is supposed to be close to being unbreakable, so that's always a nice thing. Moving on to the speed of the phones, the S5 uses a Qualcomm Snapdragon 800 chip with a clock speed of 2.5 GHz and is a quad-core chip. The phone also has 2 GB of RAM. Now, the iPhone 6 will be packing Apple's new A8 chip. This is speculated to have a clock speed of 2.6 GHz and could be a quad-core chip. The iPhone is also speculated to have 1 GB of RAM like the iPhone 5S did. Now, all of these specs are completely useless if your phone is dead. So the S5 has a battery capacity of 2800 mAh. Along with KitKat and the new optimizations, the S5 delivers good battery life, and for most people it can last a whole day. Now, the last-gen iPhone, the 5S, uses a battery that has a capacity with about 1500 mAh. Although this does look weak, the iPhone, along with iOS 7, is able to manage the iPhone's usage and be more efficient, ultimately giving this phone about the same battery life as the Samsung phones, even though the capacity is a lot less. Now, the iPhone 6 will either have about the same capacity as the last-gen iPhone, or it could have even less, along the lines of maybe 1200 mAh. The downsize of the battery in the iPhone 6 could be because of how thin the phone is going to be, and the lack of space. The new A8 chip that will be found in the iPhone 6 will be even more efficient at saving battery life than the last-gen chip was. To conclude, the iPhone 6 should have about the same battery life as the iPhone 5S did, even if it does have a smaller battery size. Lastly, let's discuss the camera on these phones. The Samsung Galaxy S5 uses a 16-megapixel lens that can take fantastically high-resolution photos and videos. There's also digital image stabilization, and it can film in UHD, so that is a nice thing to have. The next-gen iPhone is either going to keep the 8-megapixel camera that is found in the iPhone 5S, but we also have reason to believe that Apple may bump up the megapixel count to 10. The big news is Apple may implement electronic image stabilization. The iPhone 5S still takes some of the best photos and videos of any phone out today, and we expect the iPhone 6 to improve upon that. With all that said, I hope you fine people did enjoy the video, and if you did, then please give the video a like down below and subscribe to the channel. Let me know in the comments down below what you think of all this fantastic technology, and I will see you in the next one. Peace, bro!
This is not the iPhone 6. This will just give me an idea of how it should feel running an operating system. Anyways, there it is. It actually looks nice. I mean, it looks so similar to this guy that I've had for a while, but it's a little heftier, and it should work. So let's go ahead and power this guy on. Hulp. Nice. Let's see what else comes in here. So, you have your earbuds, guess a little touch stylus, the wall adapter in here. What? No stickers. Huh. Alright, so that's that. Anyways, here it is. That's the iPhone 6 running an iOS 7 skin on Android. I mean, why couldn't they do it after iOS 8? I don't know, but there it is. So I went ahead and set it up and spent a little time with the system. Now, first off, it took me a while to get it out of Chinese. Everything was in Chinese. I had a hard time accessing the menus to change it to English language. Now, this whole thing is so funny to me. It's trying to be an iPhone 6 running an old version of Android, like 4.0.4, that's trying to run iOS 8 while running an iOS 7 skin. It's a mess. I can't even put my mind around what it's supposed to be. So in a summary, I'd pretty much say it's like Android is attempting to be iOS 8 while keeping all of the lagginess and just inconsistency of Android inside the system. And while that's not Android's fault, it's a developer's fault, I would say that anyone who buys this phone pretty much buys it to show off. I mean, hey, I've got the iPhone 6 before anybody else. And God damn it, just go back. It's so frustrating to use this. I just spent like 10 minutes with it, and I have a hard time even going back. So this thing is usable. You gotta get to know a little bit. It is a capacitive touchscreen, so that's good. However, it's so frustrating. You'll constantly see yourself trying to get somewhere and having to spend like a few seconds clicking on a button to get there. Software updates isn't even there. It's just missing. It's like a setting that's inside the phone that's not there. They want you to think that there's updates, but there will never be an update. This is the only version you're ever going to see on this phone. Now, while it holds true to the iPhone 6 design, I like that about it. I mean, it's pretty much, you can go into public and people will think you're using a rumored iPhone 6 device, which is pretty cool. Now, with my long fingers, using the 4.7-inch display was actually really comfortable. I can't see if anyone else with short fingers would find that as enjoyable. However, I was surprised. It was more usable than I thought it would be. And in comparison to the iPhone 5 right here, you can see the screen is a bit bigger, so you would have to adjust to it for a little bit. However, I personally didn't have any trouble with that. So in comparison, when the iPhone 6 is out, I think I'll get along just fine. Let me show you how frustrating this is, how inconsistent it is. There's a fingerprint lock option, while the home button is just a plastic home button. There's no actual reason for having it there, but they put it in. There's so many settings that just don't do anything. They're just there just for show. Siri is not Siri, it's Google Voice. However, they do have a Siri option in settings. And there will be moments where you're using iOS, and then boom, it just goes to Android. And you're like, what the heck? And this was just kind of funny to me. If you slide over, the iPhone 6 on iOS 8 has been jailbroken already. There's Cydia. Well, not really. It's actually Super User, but that was just kind of funny to me that they would even include that in here. So to summarize all of this, this is Android that reproduced with iOS and created this abomination. The camera is terrible.